Have you ever dreamed about quitting your day job, doing exactly what you really, really love, and making a fortune? The woman you're about to meet did just that. She started a business pairing booze with cupcakes, and her story is now being told in this commercial.
I feel like I know her already. So here with her very sweet story is the owner and operator of Sweet Revenge, Marlo Scott. Good to see you in person.
Nice to meet you.
You're a genius.
Oh, go on.
He's been talking about it all morning, beer and cupcakes. Well, why didn't we think of that?
The thing is, Sweet Revenge, first of all, let's start there, because there's a reason why you call your company that, which is...
That is correct. I was laid off from my job in publishing back in 2007, and luckily I'd been baking cupcakes for my friends on the weekends, and I'd been doing my homework on the weekends as well in terms of writing a business plan. So when I got my pink slip, I knew what I was going to do. I was going to be hell-bent on bringing to life my business plan, and it is my sweet revenge on the man.
So now let's take the next logical step. So you're baking cupcakes, and what, you're sipping some booze while you're baking them? You go, well, hey, this kind of works.
Well, sort of, yeah, for the most part. What was happening is on the weekends, when I would make my cupcakes and meet up with my friends, what we were doing was, frankly, just enjoying the fact that we were not at the office, and so we were celebrating with a little, you know, glass of bubbly or good beer, and... lo and behold, it actually worked. And I was doing research, you know, around that time about restaurant trends and what was working, and I found out that French bistros were extremely successful concepts compared to other restaurant concepts. And I kind of anecdotally tied that back to my own life and where did, you know, my friends and I go out. And sure enough, it was kind of all of these Keith McNally restaurants that are wildly successful around town. And so I realized it's a kind of an escapist, indulgent, sexy kind of world-inspired thing that was going on in these environments, and I figured out that I could, you know, invest my life savings and create my own bit of that escape.
But you launched this business during the recession.
I did.
So was it the escape element that people still come to your restaurant because it's a feel-good thing?
I think there's definitely that aspect of it. I think that people appreciate that what I'm doing is, I'm just a normal person, but I decided to take the big leap of faith and bet on myself, and I was willing to, you know, put my money where my mouth was, and so people appreciate that it's authentic. You know, I'm getting to live my dream. Mm-hmm. I'm getting to have a ton of fun hustling booze and cupcakes, and it really, you know, people seek me out. They're there for that escape and that inspiration.
Here's what's cool about you. You're saying booze and cupcakes. People go, oh, well, wait a second. Am I cheating on my diet? But you're in such great shape. And
this is what happens to you if you have my booze and cupcakes.
That's what I need to say it, but that's what people think.
You know what? They should think that, and that is the truth. If they want to come behind the bar with me, you open enough wine bottles, you get good arms. So.
But the question is, are you successful because of the commercial, or were you in the commercial because of your success?
I'd say I was in the commercial because of my success. Ink from Chase, I think, really appreciated that I'm innovative, I'm a free spirit. I think they're championing, obviously, small business and embracing that kind of spirit of the individual, where you're taking a bet on yourself and you're living your dream and you're running your small business. You're, you know, working as hard as you can to make the dream come true.
So your message to anyone else right now, a lot of people out of work.
Yeah.
They have a lot of good ideas.
And they should actualize on those ideas and really just, I always advise aspiring entrepreneurs to do their homework. I spent a lot of nights and weekends at the Science Industry and Business Library here in town. I spent a lot of time scoping out the competition and studying their business models. I talked to as many people as I could. I took classes in the restaurant industry.
But now you're so famous, you got to wear a hat and glasses to scope them out.
Yeah, I got to put on my shades.
And the moral of the story is drink while you're doing your little...
That's one of the morals I get from this.
Exactly.
All right, beer and cupcakes after the show. Marlo Scott, thanks so much.
Hey, thank you so much. My pleasure.